change for those of us who wanted to believe that it could go on forever. And the sudden, numbing death of John Lennon signaled the end of even the dream that the past could somehow be revived. For Paul, life after the Beatles became a challenge to the resilient, positive spirit he seems to have always had. He made a headlong charge into new media, playing new music before a new audience, converting new listeners.
I decided early on that I wanted to carry on being a singer, working with a band, and I had no band. The songwriters that we loved. I mean, I was out to become like another Cole Porter. Still am, babe. It's sort of this moment, this now, if you could just appreciate it all the time. And now is never very important to most people. It's really all you've got.
As long as you and I are here, put it there.
Pluck out of the air, from out of one's soul, music that we've never heard before, but which is instantly familiar and immediately unforgettable. Songs that stir something in us, anthems of the spirit. This is Paul McCartney's special gift, and it's a gift he bears so simply, so naturally, and with such grace. It's as if the songs are coming through him from some magic place. Through him and to us, and we're all brought closer together by raising our voices and singing along. It's as if we're sitting around the stereo like some futuristic campfire and being warmed by his voice, his music, his particular joy. Ladies and gentlemen, Paul McCartney.
Thank you.
read this to you, dear. The trustees of the National Academy of Recording Arts and Sciences present the Lifetime Achievement Award to Paul McCartney, who, as a member of the Beatles, had an impact not only on rock and roll, but on Western culture, and who, as a solo performer and songwriter, continues to astonish after three decades. Oh.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now stop that, you chuck out this button, I'm warning. Hold on. Now seriously, folks, thank you, Meryl. Okay, I'm not nervous, right? Let's get that out of the way. Thank you, Meryl, I remember you well. Row 116, I remember a lot. She looked great, even then. Okay, speech time. Reaches in pocket for a little yellow slap of... Okay, guys. I'm gonna do it, don't worry. Okay. When I was but a child in Liverpool, I was listening to the radio, and this record came on. It's called What Did I Say? And it was by a guy called Ray Charles. And I was this big, and the tingles went right up and down my spine, and right there, I knew what I wanted to do in life. A little later, there was this guy called Little Stevie Wonder who had a record called Fingertips. Had the same effect on me. So, if you'd have told me that all this time later they were going to be here tonight singing something I'd written, well, I wouldn't have believed you. I mean, that's all there is to it. A little later on, I joined the best band in the world. And I've got to take this opportunity, now that I got this award here, to thank John, George, and Ringo for being beautiful people. Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to just take 1 second, because the other thing, if you'd have told me, when I reached this age, if you'd have told me that there'd be a hole in the sky, if you told me that the rain would have acid in it, and if you told me that there'd be pollution in the seas and on the land, that's something else I wouldn't have believed. But you know what? I've got faith we're going to clean it up. Because if you'd have told me that the Berlin Wall had come down and Mr. Mandela would be free, I wouldn't have believed that either. But I believe it now. If you told me I'd still be rocking after all these years, I wouldn't have believed that either. Okay. So, I say this whole thing for me has been like a bit of a dream anyway, my whole career to this date, my whole life to this date, in fact. But I'd like to just thank Linda and my kids for being incredible support to me. I love them. I'd like to thank my mum and dad, without whom I'd like to thank you all for being in my dream.